वसुदेवसुतं देवं कंसचाणूरमार्दनं देवकी परमानंदं कृष्णं वंदे जगद्गुरुं गुरुब्रह्मा गुरुविष्णु गुरुदेवो महेश्वर गुरु साक्षात् परब्रह्म तस्मै श्री गुरुवे नमः। I welcome everyone who are in the temple as well as who are online. We are studying Srimad Bhagavad Gita every Wednesday 6 to 6:45 and we are going to continue that journey. Why we have to study Srimad Bhagavad Gita? Srimad Bhagavad Gita kyun study karni hai? We always talk about it and we have to recollect it every time. Jyada paisa milega iske liye. Swarg ki prapti hogi. Yeah, we will get more money. We'll go to heaven and we will have a lot of fun over there. Or God will be very happy and we will get the moksha. Why we have to study Srimad Bhagavad Gita? And if it is that case, then why we have to study it here? Ruthi ke upar kyon Gita padhni chahiye? Gita is, in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, there are five people who are talking. Five people have talked in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. पांच लोगों के श्लोक है. कौन कौन है? संजय, who is seeing what is being told by which is being discussed on the battlefield of Kurukshetra. One is seeing it. One is a blind person. Dhritarashtra is curious. What is happening? हाँ, मेरे और पांडु पुत्रों ने क्या किया? क्या हुआ? He is so curious. He is blind, but he is very curious. He wants to know. And then we know Krishna talked a lot in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Arjun talked a lot in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Who is the fifth person? Fifth person is told to be talking indirectly. And that is Duryodhan. Mahati Chamom. He goes to the Drona and he is explaining about his about the battlefield, about the the warriors on each side. So there are slokas by Duryodhan also. All these five people have spoken in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. All these five people are married. All five of them are married. All five of them are sansari. When there are married people talking, about some points, some concerns, it should be the topic for the married people. It should be the topic for the sansaris, isn't it? It should not be topic for the, those who have left the sansara. So moksha and swarga is not the objective of the Srimad Bhagavad Gita. Srimad Bhagavad Gita objective is to how to live happily in this world. How to behave in proper way in this world. And that is why it is important. Srimad Bhagavad Gita sadhu sannyasiyon ke liye nahi hai. It is for sansaris. It's a guide for sansaris. When all the people who are living in the sansar and who are acting in the sansar, they are talking about something, naturally it is for them. It is not for the people who are thinking that अरे मुझे स्वर्ग की, हाँ मुझे स्वर्ग मिलेगा. गीता पढ़ूंगा 18 अध्याय के 700 श्लोक पे बायट कर दूंगा, मुझे बहुत पुण्य मिलेगा. नहीं, ऐसा नहीं. अच्छा तो फिर क्या मिलेगा? Then what will I get? Because we always do like that, isn't it? क्या मिलेगा? Why should I study? Why should I get? What will I get? You will get a direction. How to live the life, that is the direction. That is why we are studying Srimad Bhagavad Gita. One fellow asked me, Srimad Bhagavad Gita, if my cycle has got punctured, motorcycle or cycle has got punctured, will I get Maharaj baithe the, he told solution of every problem is in Srimad Bhagavad Gita. So this boy asked, if my bicycle has got puncture, is there a solution in Srimad Bhagavad Gita how to repair the puncture? Srimad Bhagavad Gita will not tell you how to repair the puncture. Srimad Bhagavad Gita will tell you how to keep your mind cool and how to decide in a proper direction so that you can do your puncture correction. That is what Gita is telling. Gita is hitting on the root cause. Gita is not just giving you solutions like Google. Gita is hitting on the root cause. And that is the root cause we are trying to understand. So we were on 25th sloka last time, and we talked about Loka Sangraha. Now, in simple language, those people who doesn't understand Sanskrit will say Loka Sangraha. Lok means people, and Sangraha means ikatta karna, make them together. Means crowd, yeah. Gathering the crowd means Loka Sangraha. That is incorrect. The meaning we last time understood it in great detail. And in that case, we took two examples of Loka Sangraha. One at individual level and one at the social or higher level. For the individual level, we talked about mother and the child. Yeah, how does a mother teach the children? When there is a little girl, 2-year-old girl, wants to play with the doll. She wants to get two doll getting married. And then doing the cooking. Ghar khelte hain. Yeah. And the mother is playing with her. Mother says, yeah, very beautiful doll, very good bride. Mother will play with the child. Mother will do, mother knows. But to get the child up to the level of understanding, she has to work. She has to play. Gudya gudi ka khel khelte hain. That is why, that is how the mother. So a jnani person, the person who wants to do Loka Sangraha, a person who is really interested. Loka Sangraha means what? It is not making the crowd, it is to motivate and lead everyone as they are. Important word is as they are. Badalte nahi hai. Jahan se hai, wahan se uthate hai. That is Loka Sangraha. That is Loka Sangraha. So mother doesn't tell the child, oh, this is a plastic material, it is not, there is nothing in it, ye toh maya hai. What you are thinking about the doll is actually maya. Aise bolne wale bhi milte hai na, sansar maya hai, chhod do. Maya hai, hai, uski na nahi hai. Magar usse chhodne ko mat kaho. Usme improve hone ke liye. Tell to improve it. Mother doesn't say the child, that you leave this doll, this is all nonsense, after 5 years you will not even look at this doll, this is all maya, forget it. No, mother plays with the doll, with the daughter, and brings her up together. That is the example of 101. And then the other example we took about was in the mass social relationship, and we took the example of Bhagwan Ram, how we took the monkeys, who is a monkey, who is a bear, who is a vulture. Yeah, we talked about it last time. So he took those people from where they are. Tum papi ho, tum badalna padega, nahi to tum nahi kar sakte. He didn't say like that. He told, you are a monkey, that is okay, no problem. You are a bear, that is okay. Utilize your energies towards a good cause, towards a cause for the upliftment of the society, whatever you are. He's not telling that you are born downtrodden, achud ho. Swarga nahi milega. No, he didn't say that. He told, okay, whatever is your capacity, utilize your capacity for the good cause. That is what the God told. That is what Ram Bhagwan ne kaha. That is Loka Sangraha. That is Loka. And hence, the wise and knowledgeable, what was the meaning of the sloka? The wise and knowledgeable, the jnani person who wants to do the work as a Loka Sangraha, should not represent or seem as unique. Unique nahi dikhna chahiye. Represent uniqueness nahi karni chahiye. They merge in the society as and like the other normal sakta people. Sakta means who are connected with the fruitive actions. So what will we learn today further? We are going to, what should a wise man not do while indulging? When a wise person is indulging with the people, what he is supposed to do and what he is not supposed to do. Yeah. What he is not supposed to do when they are working with the ignorant person. Asakta and sakta person difference. And why an ignorant person behaves in an uncontrolled manner. That's another thing. There are so many shlokas in Gita also. अर्जुन आज पाप क्यों होता है, आदमी पाप क्यों करता है. सो दिस इज द सम ऑफ द दोस क्वेश्चंस एंड व्हाट कॉजेस हिम टू बिहेव लाइक दैट इग्नोरेंट. व्हाई डज एन इग्नोरेंट पर्सन बिहेव लाइक दैट? दैट इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न टुडे. And why we are learning that? Because ignorant person feels greed, pain, depression and unhappiness. Ignorant means one who is attached to the fruitive action. Jisko karma ke phal mein jyada aasakti hai for that person. Why? Because he will be unhappy. Any fruit will be get, as we already talked around 5 sessions before, whatever fruits, whatever results we get, it is always going to be different than what is expected. It is always going to be different than what is expected. So the difference in expectation and the result will create further ripple actions. If the fruits are much better than expectation, then the greed happens. I wanted a job of $40,000, but I got a job of $50,000. Now I want a job of $70,000. Why? Because the fruits are going to increase more and more satisfaction. And if the fruits are not enough as per the expectation, depression, anger. So, getting connected with the fruit itself is a problem, and that is what is to be resolved. And that is why we will go to the 26th sloka, where the Jnani Purush, the wise man, should do in what way when they are indulging with the or coming in contact with the Ajnani person. Na buddhi bhedam janayed अज्ञानं कर्म संगिनां जोषयेत् सर्वकर्माणि विद्वान् युक्तः समाचरन्. What does it mean? बुद्धि भेदम न means no, न बुद्धि भेदम जनयेत्. Discord in the intellect. बुद्धि में भेद मत जनरेट करो. Don't generate it. जनयेत् should create. Agyanam of the ignorant people, karma sanginam, who are attached to the fruitive action. Do not create the doubts and the discord in the intellect of the agyani person. Agyani means those who are attached to the fruitive action. Who should not do that? Josayet sarva karmani. Should not be Josayet. Josayat should inspire them, rather you should be inspiring them, sarva karmani, in all the prescribed duties. Vidwan, the knowledgeable person, the wise person, yukta, enlightened, samacharan, performing properly. That means a intelligent, a vidwan person should also do the same action, but intelligently, and be with that person. It's taking the same example of the mother and the child. Imagine the mother knows that this is a doll, this is a wrong, it's just a plastic material, and mother doesn't give the impression, the affection, doesn't show the emotion of doll, you know, two doll and the male and the female doll getting married or like that. What will happen? The child will be happy? Nahin, child will not be happy. मदर शुड से माँ बोलना चाह रही, वाह कितनी बढ़िया गुड़िया रखी है, कितना बढ़िया गुड्डा है, चलो बढ़िया से शादी बनाते हैं. दैट इज व्हाट मदर शुड से. इवन दो द मदर नोज क्लियरली दैट द प्ले इज नॉट राइट, द प्ले इज माया, बट स्टिल द मदर शुड नॉट से टू द चाइल्ड, इजंट इट? दैट इज व्हाई द प्ले इज देयर. इसलिए तो मजा आएगा प्ले का. It is our everyday experience. So that is how, and that is why Josayat, they should encourage the person, Samacharan, in the same way, Samacharan, in the same way they should behave, and they should, they should actually motivate them to do their prescribed duties. Prescribed duties. What is the prescribed duty of a child at that moment? To play the parents for the doll, for their marriage. So prescribed it is, that is to be done. So usually people in the material conscious, how we will say about the jnani, this is an important message. Usually people in the material consciousness consider only two options. Either they are willing to work hard for fruitive results. Yeah. What are the two things they do? Either जो लोग होते हैं क्या करते हैं, या तो संसार में डूब जाना ऐसा कहते हैं, हाँ, either they are willing to work hard for fruitive results, or they wish to give up all the exertions and the pleya for all the work that are laborious, painful and wrought with evil. या तो बोलते हैं संसार है वो हमें चाहिए ही नहीं. What two kind of people are there? One is telling, I don't believe in ये सब God भी छोड़ो, all this heaven भी छोड़ो. What is this? मुझे अभी क्या मिलता है, है ना? That is what people talk. What I need now, and I work in the material world, in the fruitive world. And the other side says, leave everything, because this is all Maya. That is what. And then there is a dilemma. There is a dilemma created. But between these, also working for result is at least far superior than escapism approach as per Gita. सब कुछ छोड़ के नहीं जा सकते, सब कुछ छोड़ना नहीं चाहिए. I always give an example. एक बड़े संत महात्मा होंगे, वो आके कहेंगे अरे दुनिया माया है, सब छोड़ दो, या leave all the world. This all this is Maya. There is nothing in this world. This is all useless. मोक्ष ही सही जगह है. Suppose there is a Maharaj is telling like that. And in the audience, suppose there are 200 people. All 200 people will agree. Yes, बराबर है. Everybody will say, today onwards, this moment onwards, we are leaving the world. हाँ, कुछ काम नहीं करेंगे. Carpenter will say, I am not going to make any woodwork. I will not make any chairs. Doctor will say, I will stop going to the dispensary. Because Maya है. Police will say, I will not stop any crimes, because whatever is happening in the world, sansar is Maya. How will the world work? World cannot work. So at least doing actions are at least that way superior than not doing anything. Gita doesn't tell us, sadhu ban jao. Gita kabhi sadhu banne ke liye nahi kehti. Gita kaam karne ke liye kehti hai. Karma ka siddhant hai. Karma ka upar vajan hai. But how will you do? Perform your duties with attentiveness and care. So when a person, a jnani person, unknowingly will start telling about the truth of the life to the ajnani person, to the fruitive action people, what will happen? There will be a dilemma. The ignorant will become disturbed and unsettled, that they may lose the faith in working altogether. Kal Maharaj ji aaye the, Maharaj ji ne kaha duniya maya hai. Now today morning I am going to the job. Maharaj ji yesterday told that duniya is maya. Should I go to the job or not? Dilemma. I am papi. I am sansari. Should I go to job or not? There will be a dilemma. A truly, truly listening person. There are other people also who will just walk out and say, "To Maharaj ji bolte hain, humko kya hai?" No, there are also people. But this is about the truly devotee person, a good-hearted person. He will start thinking, "What I am doing is correct or wrong?" So, a truly wise person should not say what you are doing is wrong. विद्वान युक्त समाचरण, rather he should also get married. कृष्ण भगवान ने शादी बनाई ना, राम ने बनाई ना शादी, सब ने शादी बनाई. हमारे जितने भी भगवान जी है सब ने शादी बनाई. Why? अगर if संसार is बुरा, then why all the gods have got married? और वही भगवान के भक्त, सेम भगवान भक्त is telling us that संसार is माया, leave it. Why should there be so many ornaments? Mataji ko dekho kitne ornaments dale hain. And then if the wife is asking, I want some ornaments, suppose in case at home. I saw one very nice ornament, I need a garland. Maya hai. If the husband says like that, what will happen? Fight. Altercation. Aisa maya hai. Zarurat nahi hai ornaments. Chale? Nahi chale. Yes. So, should not do that. Ignorant will be disturbed and unsettled. They may lose the faith, their action may stop, and out of that the knowledge doesn't arise. Keech liya, if you want to do something, but I am telling you that this is wrong and I am going to pull it away from you, you will be unhappy in the life. Sadhu banne ke baad mein bhi uski keech to wahi rahegi. He has still got the same attraction and the greed and envy and anger even after leaving the society. So it doesn't resolve the problem for that person.
So if a jnani person will say like that, what will happen? The ajnani person, the ignorant person, he will be losing from both sides. He will lose the interest in the work and he will not be able to attain even the understanding. Mother doesn't do like that. Mother play with the child. Mother play with the child. Bhagavan Ram told, no problem. Rakshasa, Kula Nikandanam. Daitya Kula Nikandanam. So what happened? He killed everyone in Lanka. Did he kill everyone in Lanka? Then how the Vibhishana will become king of Lanka? Who will he rule? He didn't. Rakshas kul ke rakshas kul ka kaam karo. Monkey hai Sugriva, aap vanar ke raja ban jao. Vanar galat hai. Convert all the people of the other faith and religion. That is not the right way. Only this one specific faith or religion is correct and all others are sinners. That's not the right thought and Gita never says that. Maybe other religions are telling that and that is incorrect. It will not make the world happy. People worshipping and doing rituals with whole heart, but with less knowledge and understanding. Bhagwan ki bhakti ke liye aate hain, worship the God. Theek hai na? Unko nahi mila, they didn't attain the moksha. But do not stop them. Let them continue. It is okay. Even with a half knowledge. Kids should keep coming to the temple. Even though they do not understand what is the true meaning of the Brahma. Aham Brahmasmi. If a person is, a person will say, suppose, take an example, a boy is told, you should learn swimming. So the boy will say, okay. So he will go to the swimming pool and he will say, unless I understand the complete technology of how a body of a human being swims in the water, I will not jump in the water. Will the child able to swim, learn swimming? No. You have to jump in. Maybe sometimes you will go in up and down, but eventually you will learn. That is how the learning of the knowledge is also there. So keep coming to the I always say, keep coming to the temple. Whatever is your level of understanding, no problem. Continue with that and come, keep coming and keep attached. One day that child who is playing with the doll will understand that this is really a maya. And in the same way, we say, aha, okay, child. No, then we grow and we really also get married. We indulge into the society. The same thing. Then we grow much older, then we find, oh, ye bhi maya hi thi. It happens. But let it come in its own way. Do not tell them. Na buddhi bhedam janayed. Buddhi bhedam na janayed. Like the mother tells. In the same way. Becoming a monk is not the only way to moksha. Everyone cannot and should not be a sadhu. That is another part. Everyone cannot live it. So you keep telling them, hey, maya, it will not work. Will not work. Telling the common people that this is the path of hell is not correct. Is not correct. Important, very important. Maya mein pade hue hai. Nark prapta hoga. No, never said. Also, those people who cannot understand the complete jnana, they will raise questions and create the disbelief. That will lead into inaction and confusion. That is another impact in the society. Rather than that, explain them to work hard with a better understanding. And that is where the Gita is coming. That is where what we are trying to. Somebody will say, "Acha, Gita ke pravachan mein bolte hain, wahan koi bhai sahab hai, wo bol rahe hain, wo bolenge to, wo sunenge na, moksh mil jayega." Nahi milega. I am telling now, you will not get moksh. If you are coming with a expectation that if I study the Gita and I will get the moksha, no. I will blindly say it. Very boldly. Because understanding comes in slowly, it comes. Bahuni me vetidani janmani tavacha. God is going to say, we are going to go through those slokas. It's not one time, it's a long term process. But try to study, keep in touch. So here, we are telling another important point is that everyone should be doing their prescribed duty. Very important part. So prescribed duty means what? That means nothing can be divided as a sinful duty or a pious duty. Sadhu Maharaj pavitra hai, और कुर्सी बनाने वाला कारपेंटर अपवित्र है. नहीं, गीता डजंट से दैट. गीता डजंट डिस्टिंग्विश बिटवीन प्रिस्क्राइब ड्यूटीज. इफ आई एम बोर्न विद समथिंग, दैट इज माय प्रिस्क्राइब ड्यूटी. दैट इज माय. जस्ट लाइक ए प्रीचर डज हिज प्रीचिंग, ए कॉबलर, ए फिशरमैन इज डूइंग हिज जॉब. दैट इज हिज प्रिस्क्राइब ड्यूटी. He is not doing a scene. So telling a person that your prescribed duty is unpious, sinful hai, tum paap karma kar rahe ho, that is wrong. It is not that. That is what it means. You do your prescribed duty, but with understanding, and we will understand how it comes. And again, in case of Bhagwan Ram, yeah, he didn't kill the people, all the people in Lanka. Rather, he made Vibhishana the king of them. That means Rakshas reh gaye na. Eventually Rakshas reh gaye ke nahi. So if the Rakshasas are already there, that means what? That means their prescribed duty should continue. Rakshas were there. Monkeys were there. Sugriv was there. Rather, he has taken, what a step he has taken. Mandodari was married to Vibhishan. Can you believe that? Even today, what are the, we have to understand Ram very deep, very, very clear. Yeah. And he did not rule Kishkindha. He told Sugriv to rule it. Aap vanar ho, vanar raho, aur vanar ka kaam karo. Sab log aadmi ban jao. No. He didn't say that. Why? That is where the Lok Sangrah is coming. Where you are, what you are, you keep doing it. But with understanding, and what understanding is going to come in the sloka. So this is proving another point also, you know, the untouchability. The major important point here is that everyone is beating on the caste system and untouchability in Sanatana Dharma. But Srimad Bhagavad Gita is clearly telling, there is no untouchability, there is no sin. There is no sin, koi paap nahi hai. अगर मैं खाटकी का बेटा पैदा हुआ हूं तो मैं खाटकी का काम करूंगा, कसाई का काम करूंगा. अगर मैं फिशरमैन में पैदा होगा, मैं फिशरमैन का काम करूंगा. आई विल डू द फिशरमैन वर्क. दैट इज माय प्रिस्क्राइब ड्यूटी. एंड दैट इज व्हाई देयर इज अ श्लोका, इट्स गोइंग टू कम. विद्या विनय संपन्ने ब्राह्मणे गवि हस्तिनी सुनिचय स्वपाके च पंडिता समदर्शिना. विद्या विनय संपन्ने, हु इज अ ज्ञानी, who is a completely wise and knowledgeable person. Vidya Vinaya Sampanna, you should get a Vinaya, you should get understanding. What? Brahmane Gavi Hastini. Brahman, a Brahmin person. Gavi, a cow. Hastini, an elephant. Shuni, a dog. And Shopak means dog eater. Shopak means dog eater. A person who has got a complete understanding is so seeing all these people, samadarshina, equal, same, it doesn't distinguish. So we were talking about the people who are doing their prescribed duty, but here it will come even for the animals. There is an equality. Ekatmata, sabme ek atma hai. Kahan se hai? Everybody has got one atma. That is ekatmata. That is what Gita is telling. And we are going to study it in detail. We are going step by step. So a wise person should not distinguish. That is what Gita says. So where does it come that, अरे तुम अच्छो तो दूर रहो, तुम मेरे पास मत आओ, तुम मुझे छुओ मत. That is a wrong concept. Gita doesn't say that. Sanatana Dharma never ever says there is somebody down and somebody up. Even in animals and insects. Forget about human being. Anybody who is talking about somebody up and down in like a caste system, caste is, by the way, it's a Portuguese word, but the caste system, there is no word of caste system in Sanatana. So Sanatana, we have to be proud of that. We never see anybody up or down. Those who follow the Sanatana Dharma never see anybody up and down. Never see somebody big and small. We are all equal, ekatmata. Rather, other religion says that if you are believing in the other religion, you are a sinful person. And there should be a punishment. Either you go to hell or we should kill you. Sanatana Dharma never says that. So we should understand and be proud of it. What Sanatana says. Vidya Vinaya Sampanne, ब्राह्मणे कवि हस्तिनी सुनिश्चयित्वा स्वपाकेच पंडिता समदर्शिनः. So now question comes that if both ignorant and the wise person perform the same prescribed action, okay, then what is the difference between them? If both of them, we are telling they should, he should do the same action. Nah, mother should also get the dolls married. If they are doing the same action, then what is the difference? And this question is understandable. And that is why Sri Krishna explains this in the further two verses. He is explaining it more further down. So I will chant 27th sloka. Prakrute kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasa ahamkara ahamkara vimudatma karta hamiti manyate. This is what is the difference. God is clearly explaining, if both are doing the same duty, both seem to be having the same thing. Huh? Somebody asks, if Shankaracharya is eating Srikhand, for example, Adi Shankaracharya, okay? Adi, not today Shankaracharya. If Adi Shankaracharya is eating Srikhand, and if we are eating Srikhand, Srikhand is a sweet by the way, or Jalebi, you know, any food by whatever we like. Okay? If Adi Shankaracharya is eating Jalebi, and if I am eating jalebi and we both are told by Gita that you should do your duty, prescribed duty, so you should do exactly the same, what is the difference? Adi Shankaracharya will not find jalebi sweet. Will his sugar level in the body will not increase? Will his tongue not feel and understand the sweetness of the jalebi like us? It will be same. Then what is the difference between Adi Shankaracharya eating jalebi and I eating jalebi? What will be the difference? That is what is explained in this sloka. Prakrute kriyamanani. Very important. Prakruti. The material nature. Prakruti means material. The material nature. Prakrute kriyamanani. Kriyamanani carried out. So here it is clearly explained between two areas. One is the material part of the life and another is the soul part of the life. How that is happening? Prakrute kriyamanani gunai karmani sarvasah. All those which is tangible, is material nature, is going to behave in its way. Shankaracharya will also have to go to the toilet because he is eating. He has to also take a bath because his material body has got its own prakriti. He has to do it. In the same way, he has to eat, he has to go to the job, like how us, we go to the job, we earn money. So prakriti has to be there. So in Hindi translation, sampurna karma sab prakar se prakriti ke guno dwara kiye jate hain. A body of Adi Shankaracharya will behave exactly the same way. Garmi mein unko bhi pasina niklega. It will exactly behave in the same way. When they are hungry, they will feel equal hunger. When they are thirsty, they will have equal thirst also. When they eat food, the saliva created in the mouth will be exactly same like what we have saliva. Then what's the difference? What's the difference? Ahamkara vimudatma karta hamidi manyate. One who believes, ahankar means, ahankar doesn't mean, means one who believes that I am the body, I am the material. That is ahankar. That person who has got that understanding, mahankar se mohit antakaran wala, agyani manushya, mai karta hoon, aisa sochta hai, aisa manta hai. He believes that I am doing it. Whereas the guni person, the wise person, will not see that as I am doing it. It is being done. That's the difference. That is the only difference. But that's a very big difference between a wise person and a ignorant person. That is the difference. Mai karta hoon, ye ignorant person kehta hai. Ignorant person says that. So here, it's very interesting to see. We learned in second chapter, who am I? My kaun hoon? My atma hoon? Na marti hai, na janma leti hai. Yeah, we learned, right? Atma cannot be burnt, it cannot be soaked in with water, it doesn't die, it doesn't burn. You cannot put it in fire and burn it. That is what we are. That is what we are told in second chapter. Atma. But then how I am a material body if I am an Atma? So because material energy pulls and needs to do the actions, our body does the actions. If you feel sneezing, you will sneeze. The body will ask you to do the sneezing. You cannot stop sneezing, even if you are the biggest jnani in the world. Somebody will say, I am the biggest jnani, I can control everything. And then suppose there is a sneezing coming, there is a lot of dust, and he has to sneeze. He has to sneeze because it's a material characteristic of a body. He has to sneeze. Similarly, we have to work. We are married, we have got family, we have got responsibility. Yeah, we have to work. What is wrong in it? There is nothing wrong in it. So, because our body does the actions, but one who does not know and understand the soul, the body and the soul difference, he thinks that I am doing it. So what happens? He gets attached to the action. Getting attached to the action is a question. When we get attached to the action, then we are infatuated. We are infatuated by three material nature. When we are attached, then the material nature comes with us. When we are not attached with material nature, it doesn't come with us. So what is the material nature? They work and express the purpose of being able to enjoy the sensual happiness and mental delights. That is what is the ignorant person thinks. Sade bhasha mein bolo bhai itna bada kya hai? Yeah, very simple. It's very Gita is actually very simple. No need to talk very high languages. But what happens that because of that they are unable to do the action as a duty and without desiring the rewards. So let us understand it in a simple version. A ignorant person thinks that I am doing a job and I will get the salary this month end and then I will buy a bicycle. Okay. Why? Because I want a bicycle and I am doing a job and so I am doing a job, I will get the salary. Now they get the salary. They get the salary, they get the bike also. There is nothing wrong in it. But the thing is, he thinks that I got it. So now it is my bike. And that is where the problem starts. My bike. And that extrapolates, you know, my bike, my house, my car, my friends, my clothes, my watch, my ornaments, everything. My. And then what happens? They get attached to it. Now, Prakruti, the material, has a nature to change. Material has a nature to change. We know everything in the world is changing. Everything in the world is changing because material has a nature to change. When the situations change, if I say that this is mine, you will be unhappy. I have a car. My car is standing in the parking area. Somebody comes and bang bang on it, unfortunately. Now, it was my car. Then you become unhappy or you become angry. Why? Because you thought that I earned it. It is your car, no doubt about it. But you thought that I earned the car. So the I part, the soul part which is within you is connected to the material world. When we attach ourselves to the material world, then there is a problem. But when you take it as a duty, it is not a problem. Let us take another example. And I always love to take this example. And this is an example of a bank cashier. In the bank, you go to the cashier. Nowadays there is ATM also, but we still have cashiers there. So you go to the cashier and you ask for money. I want $1,000. He gives you. Another guy comes. The cashier is giving maybe $50,000, $100,000 a day. He is giving away that money. Does he feel unhappy? Aaj maine 1000 logo ko, today I paid 50,000, 50,000 maine de diya. No. Why? Mera duty hai. It's my duty. So you have got the money in hand. You are counting it. You are taking care of it. You are preserving it, you are saving it, you are keeping it in safe. Everything you are doing, you are making the register, how much money has been given to whom and all that. But you are untouched. Why? I have a duty, I am a cashier, this is my duty. So doing the same thing, doing the same actions everywhere, if we take that as a duty, and duty of what and whom? Duty of soul towards the creator. If we take that as a duty, there is unattached. And when there is unattached, there is a happiness. That is how the unattachment is important. लोग बोलते हैं माया है, छोड़ दो माया है. माया कैसे छोड़ेंगे? माया नहीं छोड़ सकते. If I'm going in my car, a brand new Tesla, and somebody comes and scratches on it, how will I not feel hurt? I should feel hurt. And so माया है, नहीं नहीं ये माया है, ये स्क्रैच नहीं है. अरे हाई सामने दिखता है, how can you say it is not a scratch? So telling that it is माया, how can it be माया? I always say, you know, if you tell Maya, for those people who are married and all, suppose there is a father who is working hard and then he goes home and his 2-year-old daughter comes, papa, papa, comes running and hugging him and then, you know, giving him a kiss. How this can be Maya? This is reality. And even if this is Maya, I am happy to be in Maya. I don't want the other thing. That is what we feel. So leaving it is not possible. So the important point is understanding the relationship. The material nature and my own is the relationship, the duty part has to be understood. Understanding the bank cashier is an excellent example to understand what is, even if it is the same action. You ask the same cashier when he's going out of the bank, there is a beggar on the side, okay? And that beggar will ask, can you give me a quarter? No. You gave $50,000 today to everybody, you are not giving me, it's mine. That quarter is mine. That quarter is mine. All that money is other. So one day we are going to leave anyway. All this will be somebody else's. How you are telling mine? That is also another way to look at it. Anyway, so in the same way, when we feel and understand that the actions and hence its results, okay, are done by me with my effort and intellect, we get attached. And this is a cause of ego and pain. And hence, ego is defined as I am doing. Rakshas. We know Rakshas hai, Asur hai. We have got we have got all these names. Bada Rakshas tha, Bali Raja tha, Asur. Rakshas tha, Ravan. So, Rakshas means what? And so, painters paint them with a nice painting, you know. A Rakshas means one who has got a long teeth and the horns and very like dark looking guy with the long nails and trying to come and kill you with the, you know, the blood coming out. Yahan bhi dekhiye mata ji ke niche jo Rakshas ko marte hain, ha, Mahishasur mardini. Okay, Rakshas kaisa dikhata hai? The teeth and all, right? But Rakshas means what? Raksha me, the person who believes that I am the owner and I can take control of myself. I am the protector. Raksha me. That person who thinks that I am a protector, that means I am in control, is Rakshas. The person who thinks that I am in control is Rakshas. Rakshas doesn't mean, Rakshas may be very beautiful. And even we have got an example also. Suparnakha came. Kaise aayi thi? How did Suparnakha come? If Suparnakha would have come with long teeth and long horns and all this blood and everything, how she can look beautiful and Ram will say to Ram and Lakshman? She became very beautiful. हम लोग पढ़ते हैं ना, सुनते हैं, we listen also. Suparnakha बहुत सुंदर होकर आई. कथाकार कहते हैं, I am not here to do the katha. But they explain it, right? Suparnakha, how beautiful she became. Rakshas doesn't mean, Rakshas means जो अपने में खुद की रक्षा मैं करता हूँ. That is what Rakshas. Asur. Asur means what? One who thinks that the bodily happiness, the happiness of the sensual happiness, is the only life. The person who thinks that is Asur. Asur doesn't mean bade baal wala, lambe daant wala. One who believes that the material body is the truth and the happiness in comforting it is the only purpose of life. That is what Asur is. So, I think it's already going to be 1 minute balance now, 6:45. So we will stop over here today and we will go to 28th sloka next week again on Wednesday, 6 to 6:45. And we will understand further how this mechanism of material world, our self and our prescribed duty. हमें काम तो करना ही पड़ेगा संसार में रहके. तो how we should be behaving, how we should be working, and with what understanding we should be working, that is in the next slokas coming. So we will come again next Wednesday here between 6 to 6:45 and try to understand from 28th sloka onwards. Till then, I wish everyone a happy week and as well as a weekend.
Vasudevasutam devam kamsa chanuramardhanam devaki paramanandam krishnam vande jagat gurum guru brahma guru vishnu guru devo maheshwara guru sakshat parabrahma tasmai shri guruve namah.